the stories have been written. But in 3 minutes, I'll say 4 things which are paramount to me. Number one, when you look at the freedom of security and integrity of the individual, beginning from yourself, freedom from hunger is about to be ruined if I don't keep my speech very short. But I'm here to speak more substantive issues. Willie Kimani et al. He's not the only person who has disappeared. He's not the only person who has been in arbitrary arrests. He's not the only person who has been extrajudicially executed. I've documented this, and we continue to document as IPOA. Our website is open. All IPOA reports, I edit them. And Manombe always gives me the title of editor-in-chief. I edit also many publications of the Kenya Human Rights Commission, which document human rights violations. The most recent being a month ago. If these reports come out, you just see the kind of issues that are coming out. I don't know how to say many stories. And I'm sure most of you are readers, don't have to be told many things. So those are things which I've spent time on. Number two, when you look at the whole gamut of articles in the Constitution, beginning with Article 238, which defines what actually is national security, incorporating both state-centric model of territorial integrity and everything else, the way we define them in those many years in political science and in law, and then you come and find also a new human-centric model which also says observance of human rights and protection and promotion, the three main obligations of human rights, you shudder in disbelief in terms of how we are conceiving the entire state security in Kenya, from many cases to few cases to killings to there are many, and I'm still documenting the same, because always KHRC gives me an opportunity to do that, and also I am given a chance by many newspapers to document the same. So these are things for those who have been keen, and because security is about you. And I'm not saying security begins with you and me. No. It is never. It's an obligation of the state to provide security. Otherwise, they should not even tax you. Why should you be taxed? You should even own a sword. Like me, I travel with one anyway.
What's a spear? Your spear?
Everything I have. Okay. I'm half Maasai, backwards. But look at the whole gamut of security in terms of fulfillment of your own identity and your human rights obligations. And I want to thank Steve for giving some accolades to IPOA, where I work. And sometimes I work in other many places. But one thing I do in all these places, I document. The third point I want to mention on this area of security of the state versus us, or human rights versus state rights, or whatever they are called, state obligations. In fact, they're not state rights. When you look at what is happening for us as IPOA, why we have distinguished ourselves away from these failing institutions. And I want to quote Akoth, Dr. Akoth, for that matter. When he says NPSC has failed, in fact, he is being lenient. It is buried. They just hear somewhere here. We I talked to them, these people, I talked to them as an individual, and I talked to them with my fellow, you may call us board members or commissioners, whatever name you want, it doesn't matter, I'm still Tom. We told them where to go, where we want to go, as Kenya, moving forward. Kimaijo, we told him, he never believed us. We told him he'd leave office before we do. He left. Kavuludi, we told him he'll be used and damned. He's on the way of being, I think, I don't know what that thing he called the new toilet of the 18th century. Yeah, something being flushed out. He's on that way. So the question is, one day I say they have no moral authority to talk about state security. Then they hated me for that. But because I know I have many friends, from those who work in the day and those who work in the night, and also I'm born from the Mau Mau. When I say something, I mean it. I don't play around. So these people, they don't hear what it's supposed to be done. And finally, my fourth and final mention is on what do I think about the Commander-in-Chief? You may quote this if you want, because we just we share a village. We got Tondo. So when I look at the entire spectrum of security in Kenya and I look at this individual called Uhuru, I wonder where does he think he will go eventually after this? Because these guys will eat him up. When you don't deal with insecurity as a state president, they will eat you up one day. And you know, this is not Jomo. This is his son. So when I look at the entire how he behaves, when he challenges us, he tries even to change the law, to remove us from office, I write to him directly. The stories have been written. But in 3 minutes, I'll say 4 things which are paramount to me. Number one, when you look at the freedom of security and integrity of the individual, beginning from yourself, freedom from hunger is about to be ruined if I don't keep my speech very short. But I'm here to speak more substantive issues. Willy Kimani et al. He's not the only person who has disappeared. He's not the only person who has been in arbitrary arrests. He's not the only person who has been extrajudicially executed. I've documented this, and we continue to document as IPOA. Our website is open. All IPOA reports, I edit them. And Manombe always gives me the title of Editor-in-Chief. I edit also many publications of the Kenya Human Rights Commission, which document human rights violations, the most recent being a month ago. If these reports come out, you just see the kind of issues that are coming out. I don't know how to say many stories, and I'm sure most of you are readers, don't have to be told many things. So those are things which I've spent time on. Number two, when you look at the whole gamut of articles in the Constitution, beginning with Article 238, which defines what actually is national security, incorporating both state-centric model of territorial integrity and everything else, the way we define them in those many years in political science and in law, and then you come and find also a new human-centric model which also says observance of human rights and protection and promotion, etc. three main obligations of human rights, you shudder in disbelief in terms of how we are conceiving the entire state security in Kenya, from many cases to few cases to killings to there are many, and I'm still documenting the same because always KHRC gives me an opportunity to do that, and also I am given a chance by many newspapers to document the same. So these are things for those who have been keen, and because security is about you. And I'm not saying security begins with you and me. No. It is never. It's an obligation of the state to provide security. Otherwise, they should not even tax you. Why should you be taxed? You should even own a sword. Like me, I travel with one anyway.
What's a spear? Your spear?
Everything I have. Okay. I'm half Maasai, backwards. But look at the whole gamut of security in terms of fulfillment of your own identity and your human rights obligations. And I want to thank Steve for giving some accolades to IPOA, where I work. And sometimes I work in other many places. But one thing I do in all these places, I document. The third point I want to mention on this area of security of the state versus us, or human rights versus state rights, or whatever they are called, state obligations. In fact, they're not state rights. When you look at what is happening for us as IPOA, why we have distinguished ourselves away from these failing institutions. And I want to quote Akoth, Dr. Akoth, for that matter. When he says NPSC has failed, in fact, he is being lenient. It is buried. They just hear somewhere here. I talked to them, these people, I talked to them as an individual, and I talked to them with my fellow, you may call us board members or commissioners, whatever name you want, it doesn't matter, I'm still Tom. We told them where to go, where we want to go, as Kenya, moving forward. Kemayo, we told him, he never believed us. We told him he'd leave office before we do. He left. Kavuludi, we told him he'll be used and damned. He's on the way of being, I think, I don't know what that thing you call the new toilet of the 18th century. Yeah, something being flushed out. He's on that way. So the question is, one day I say they have no moral authority to talk about state security. Then they hated me for that. But because I know I have many friends from those who work in the day and those who work in the night. and also I'm born from the Mau Mau. When I say something, I mean it. I don't play around. So these people, they don't hear what it's supposed to be done. And finally, my fourth and final mention is on what do I think about the Commander-in-Chief? You may quote this if you want, because we just we share a village. We got Tondo. So when I look at the entire spectrum of security in Kenya and I look at this individual called Uhuru, I wonder where does he think he will go eventually after this? Because these guys will eat him up. When you don't deal with insecurity as a state president, they will eat you up one day. And you know, this is not Jomo. This is his son. So when I look at the entire how he behaves, when he challenges us, he tries even to change the law, to remove us from office, I write to him directly, and of course appears in the paper. I tell him to go. I'm sorry, this language is not allowable here because I can see there is a law student. But you know what I mean. You tell somebody that you cannot challenge our authority. Then he says he wants to even ask to serve as, what do you call it that, during that old constitution?
Pleasure
of the president. How? And the people want to resign. I say, resign for who? For this fellow? In fact, he's a traitor. So, we stay strong, and that's why me and Steve are committed to this project. We will audit what we have to audit. I'll put my name, it doesn't matter. Because some of us are born of that legion.